Good afternoon, dear students. In this session, we'll discuss a straight wire of 200 gram and length 1.5 meter carries a current of 2 ampere. It is suspended in mid-air by uniform horizontal magnet field B. What is the magnitude of the magnetic field? I need to calculate magnetic field. The diagram is shown here. And we'll take care of this numerical. This is a question where we have a first worked example where you have a wire of length 1.5 meter. It carries a current of 2 ampere. The mass of the wire is 200 gram. Current is 2 ampere. Calculate the magnitude. What is the question? Like this is your, my scale is like a wire. Current is moving, take for example, current is moving in this direction, the length of the wire, 1.5 meter, mass 200 gram. Now I am holding, that's why it is in this position. The moment I remove my support, this is going to go down. Now what is the question? You have wire, this is a wire, it is suspended in midair, means nobody is holding it, but the magnetic field, it is attracted towards earth because of mass and gravity, downward force, there's a downward force. Somebody need to have an equal and opposite force, which should hold it in equilibrium, that is in mid-air, suspended in mid-air. The question is suspended in mid-air. Two forces are acting. One, gravitational force is equivalent to which force? Magnetic force. This magnetic force comes into picture because there is a current in a wire and because of a length. So this magnetic force, as we know, I L cross B. Since this I L cross B, what I'm considering, this magnetic force is given by I L B. So of course you have a cross product. This will become simply mathematically, I will have a simple equation. And what is mass into gravity? It is M into G. When it is suspended in midair, this formula simply reduces to I L B equal to mg. So you need to calculate what is a magnetic field. Magnetic field is given by, you have a simple mass into gravity in the denominator I into L. Do substitute the values of the mass. I will put it, mass is 200 gram. 200 gram means 0.2 kg. Gravity 9.8. Then current 2 ampere, length 1.5 meter. These two will celebrate, it is 1, it is 10. 10 into 1.5 becomes 15. So finally it is 9.8 divided by 15. Almost it is 10 by 15. It is close to 10 by 15. I can say 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is equivalent to, I hope all are familiar, most of you are very good. It is close to 0.67 Tesla. The unit is this. Let me continue the next numerical. This numerical satisfies. There are two forces, Fm equal to Fg. We equated, we got the answer. Yes. Next numerical, where if the magnetic field is parallel to the positive y-axis and the charged particle is moving along the positive x-axis, which way would the Lorentz force be? For two cases, an electron, which is negative in charge, and a positive charge, that is a proton, B. I'll repeat the question. If the magnetic field is parallel to the positive y-axis and the charged particle is moving along the positive x-axis, which way would the Lorentz force, and for an electron, for a proton? This is a second worked example where the question is, what is the direction of magnetic field if the particle moves along x-axis is electron and if the particle moves along x-axis is proton? Let me take first example. You have x-axis, you have z-axis, y-axis. X-axis, y-axis, z-axis. X-axis is in the plane of a board, z-axis is in the plane of board, whereas y-axis, positive y-axis, is into the board. Into the board means cross. If it is coming out of the board like this, if it is perpendicular to the board, it is called a dot. Dot out of plane, out of plane. And if it is a cross, into the plane, into the plane. So the question is, in the first case, if this velocity is the velocity of a charged particle, the charged particle is electron. If it is an electron, if electron is there, Q is an electron, its velocity is V, it crosses magnetic field, what is the magnetic force for the electron? If Q is a charge, if the charge is electron, that is minus E, velocity is x-axis into cross. I can say minus x-axis cross plus y-axis, which gives me minus of z-axis. My magnetic force is along minus z-axis, that is downward. This is called magnetic force of the electron, the first part. And similarly, if I go for the second particle, the proton, if I write it the same, magnetic force due to proton is given by charge velocity into magnetic field. This charge is now plus E, because proton means it has a charged particle, plus E, velocity is V cross B. Again, it is x-axis cross plus y-axis, which is z-axis. Your magnetic force is along z-axis. The proton moves along this direction. Proton moves along positive z-axis. Electron moves along, it moves along negative z-axis. It moves along positive z-axis. I will repeat. When electron moves along x-axis, if magnetic field is along positive y-axis, the direction of the magnetic force on the electron is negative z-axis. It is called minus z-axis. Instead of an electron, if you have a particle proton, if it is moving along x-axis and the magnetic field is still plus y-axis, it is x cross y, which gives you a plus z. It's a cross product. The magnetic force is along plus z direction. We'll move to the next numerical where we'll discuss 4.3. Very simple numerical. What is the radius of the path of an electron? Mass of electron is 31 kg, that is minus 31 kg, charge is minus 19 coulomb. The particle is moving at a speed of 3 into 10 raised to 7 meter per second in a magnetic field of minus 4 Tesla, perpendicular to it. Means the direction of the particle and the magnetic field are 90 degree apart, means 90 degree to each other. What is its frequency? We need to calculate what is its frequency. Calculate its energy. There are two things I need to calculate, frequency and energy. The question is very interesting. One electron volt equal to minus 19 joules. Just go through it. In this numerical, I have a particle which is moving along particular axis. Consider the electron is moving along this direction, call it as plus x, charge for electron moving along x with velocity v. And your magnetic field is in this direction, perpendicular to it, b. Take it is x axis, now call it as y axis, y axis. Now the question is, what is the frequency? And the second one, what is energy? Energy means kinetic energy. To calculate frequency, we have a simple rule. Kinetic energy is given by half m v square. Whereas frequency is equivalent to 1 upon time period. Yes, this is rule. We know that radius is equal to mv upon qb. At the same time, also angular frequency equal to v by r, and this is equal to v divided by mv, it becomes qb. These two will celebrate, left with qb upon s, you have m. This omega can be written as, do remember, it is written as 2 pi frequency. Now I equate these two. I'm interested in frequency. Now frequency is equivalent to qb divided by 2 pi m. Charge is 1.6 minus 19. Magnetic field is 6 minus 4. And you have a 3.14. You have mass of the electron, 9.11, 10 raised to minus 31 kg. You simplify it, you'll get some value. So after simplifying this whole analysis, you met frequency is equal to close to 1.7, 10 raised to 6.8 or 7, 10 raised to 6, I think 10 raised to 7 hertz. Or I can roughly say close to, it is 17 megahertz. The second part of the question is energy. As I said, kinetic energy. K equal to 1 by 2, mass of the electron minus 31. Then you have velocity, it is 3 square into 7 means 14. It becomes finally, I need to convert it. It is 1 by 2, it is a 9. 9 into 81, you can say take it as 84 by 2, rough value, minus 31 plus 14, left with minus 17. Then finally we have an answer, it is something like 42 into 10 raised to minus 17 joules. And I need to convert into electron volt, divide it by 1.6, 10 raised to minus 19. This minus 19, these two will take care. Finally, 1.6, 16, 3 joule, something like, I'll get close to 1.6, 1.6, 3.2, roughly 2.5 or 2.6, or I can say 2.7, 10 raised to, it is, already it is 42, you can take it as close to 27, 10 raised to minus 19 becomes plus 2 electron volt. Yes, the energy associated the moving electron comes out to be 27 into roughly 27 into plus 2 electron, or I can further write it is 2.7, left with plus 3 means kilo electron volt. Kinetic energy associated with the electron is close to the order of 3 kilo electron volt. Kilo electron volt means kilo means plus 3 electron volt is the energy associated with a moving charged particle. Next numerical we will have 4.4, where an cyclotron's oscillator frequency is 10 megahertz. Frequency of a device which operates at 10 megahertz. What should be the operating magnetic field for accelerating protons, positive charged particles? If the radius of the disc is 60 centimeter, what is its kinetic energy? What is the kinetic energy in mega electron volt produced, mega electron of proton beam produced by the accelerator? The given datas are electronic charge, mass of the proton, as well as 1 mega electron volt is equivalent to 1.6 minus 13 joules. Let me calculate the operating magnetic field. The given numerical is, you have an accelerator which is called cyclotron, which accelerates charged particles. The example is proton, which has a mass, which has a charge property. The cyclotron frequency is given, operating cyclotron. What is the operating magnetic field? What is the required magnetic field? It is called operating magnetic field. We know that, yes, frequency is given by the product of charge, magnetic field into 2 pi m, that is mass of the particle. Yes, the charge is 1.6 minus 19. The magnetic field we are interested in the denominator 2 pi. It is 2 into 3.14 into mass of proton. That is mass of proton is 1.67, 10 raised to minus 27. Of course, frequency is given. Let me write it B here. B is equivalent to everything. Frequency is 10 raised to, this is 10 raised to 7 into 2 into 3.14 into 1.6 into minus 27. In the denominator, you have 1.6 minus 19. Minus 19 will become plus 19. This 1.6, 1.6 into 1.6, 3.2. So take it as 1, 2. 2 to the 4, 4 into something like this. 16, 4, just 64, 6.4 roughly. I can take 1.6, can take it double, it becomes 2. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 1.6, 6.4 into, it is plus 2. Then this is, of course, plus 21. It becomes 10 raised to minus 6. B means Tesla. So you can say 0.64 minus 5 Tesla. Because we have minus 27, 7, okay, sorry. 7, it becomes minus 20, left with only 1. Sorry, it is just minus 27, it becomes minus 8, plus it becomes minus 1. Finally, this is going to be your answer. You will have just Tesla. Yes, I repeat, plus 7, plus 19, it becomes 26, 26 minus 1, minus 1, 1.6 into 2 or 3.2, something like finally it becomes all 1.6, 1.6 cancels. It becomes roughly 3.6.2 into simple answer. No need to nullify it also, you'll get the answer. The final answer is 6.64 Tesla. Now what is the kinetic energy? The formula is K equal to half mv square. We don't know what is the energy. So to calculate velocity, let me go to the formula. What is the velocity formula? You have every analysis. Omega equal to V by R. To calculate V, it becomes V equal to omega R. So V equivalent to omega means 2 pi frequency into R. And let me calculate. This value is very interesting. This formula, you will get a velocity. Once you calculate a velocity, you can easily calculate what is the kinetic energy. And the kinetic energy comes out to be in mega electron volt. Yes. The radius of the D is 60 centimeter. It is a given data. Once it is 60 centimeter, 0.6 meter, you have formula 2 into 3.14 into frequency. Frequency, we have already 10 raised to plus 7. Let me put it here. Velocity equal to 2 into 3.14 into frequency 10 raised to 7 hertz into radius 0.6 meter. You simplify all this value, you'll get as it is. 0.6 into 2 is 1.2. 1.2 into this, you'll get close to. Finally, you will get 3.7 plus 7, it becomes plus 1 meter. You will have a velocity. Once you get a velocity, put it into this formula is very simple, like half, it is 1 by 2, mass is 1.67, proton mass plus minus 27, velocity, you have 3.7, 10 raised to 7 whole square. Simplified, the answer is in million electron volt. First, you'll get answer in joules. Then you convert into million electron volt. Once you substitute the values for mass and velocity, once you square it, your simplification will end up with 7 mega electron volt.